This video will show the FPGA hardware implementation for the WiMAX software-defined radio IQ modulator design, which is an example that ships with a SystemVue example set. It can be found under Examples, Hardware Design, SDR. In addition, there are three tutorial videos which show the design of the fixed point IQ modulator, HDL generation, and HDL co-simulation. This final video will show the FPGA hardware implementation of that design. This slide shows the FPGA flow that is used to implement the design in FPGA hardware. In the previous videos, we showed how SystemVue was used to design the mobile WiMAX fixed point IQ modulator. From the fixed point design, we generated HDL code. We then co-simulate the HDL together with the Xilinx VSA software to demodulate the resulting mobile WiMAX waveform to verify functionality. In this video, we'll move the HDL code into an FPGA synthesis tool. We'll run through synthesis, place and route, generate a bit file, and download that bit file to the FPGA target. The FPGA target being used produces both digital and analog outputs, so we can demodulate the digital output with an Xilinx logic analyzer, or demodulate the analog output with an Xilinx MXA signal analyzer or an Infiniium scope. This is the Xilinx ISE project that is used for synthesis. In this project, we move the SystemVue HDL code into the ISE project. You can see that we have various source files. The source files are the HDL code that have been generated from the fixed point design in SystemVue. Now let's go ahead and perform our synthesis. So I'll right click on this and click Rerun All. Synthesis has completed. We can now download the bit file to the FPGA target. Now that we've generated the bit file, we can download it to the FPGA target. The FPGA target is an Nallatech FPGA board. It contains two FPGAs, a Vertex 2 and a Vertex 4. We'll begin by downloading a bit file to the Vertex 2. And this bit file allows us to route in an external clock into the Nallatech FPGA board to clock our user design, which is our IQ modulator, as well as the DDA converters. Okay, so the bit file download has completed, and now let's download the user bit file. This is the bit file that corresponds to our IQ modulator, which we had synthesized previously in this video. The bit file has downloaded, and now we can test the FPGA output with Xilinx test equipment. And this is the test setup with an Xilinx Infiniium scope connected to the FPGA board's DDA converter output. Here we're using VSA software installed in the Infiniium scope to demodulate the DDA converter output. You can see the constellation, the spectrum, and resulting EVM. Thank you for your time today.